game controller does not work very well with DOSBox at all. It doesn't take many attempts at making them cooperate to come to this conclusion. Fear not though, I have discovered a single method that makes the two work perfectly. I discovered this method via Steam guide that was written by Kevin Connolly and, with their permission, will be presenting that method in this video. A link to the guide can be found in the description for those wanting to peruse through that as well. While the core information will be identical to the guide, I will be expanding on the source material to explain how to easily set this up for DOS games with their original files, as well as DOS games purchased through GOG. I'll explain at the end why I'm not including a method for getting this to work with DOS games purchased through Steam. As usual with my videos, timestamps are located in the description for those wanting to jump between chapters or topics in the video. To start with, what exactly are the two issues that are preventing the use of the Steam controller with DOSBox? The primary issue is that DOSBox, by default, doesn't use a display output that Steam can hook into. This results in the problem where games run through DOSBox will use the desktop config rather than an application-specific config. The second is that even when switching to an output that Steam can hook into, the overlay is extremely sluggish, with most FPS counters reading 1-2 frames per second. As Kevin puts it, the Steam overlay, which is required for proper Steam controller usage, injects itself into the render pipeline of the game, in this case DOSBox. But the way DOSBox updates the frames is not typical for most apps or games. What it does is only updates the parts of the screen that have made a change. The problem arises in how the Steam overlay interacts with only partial updates. If the game is not updating the whole frame, then the overlay won't either, as it relies upon the DOSBox's pipeline to the GPU to update itself. This can cause the overlay to seem to stop responding, or sometimes just crash. So, this fix will force DOSBox to utilize the video output that Steam can hook into and force DOSBox to update the entire frame on each vertical refresh. Being that we are forcing DOSBox to fully refresh the screen more often than it does by default, this method does impact performance. But given just how powerful modern systems are, this won't be noticeable at all. I include this point though, just in case anyone is attempting to use this fix on older hardware or less powerful devices like netbooks. Alright, the first step is to get the right version of DOSBox. The version that comes with most DOS games on GOG is the latest official branch, version 0.74, and hasn't been updated since May 2010. While it's perfectly fine for running these games under the default settings, it lacks the features that we need to get the Steam controller working. Instead, we will be using a fork of DOSBox called SVN DOM. I've included a link in the description to the official download, as well as a personal Google Drive mirror should the official link die one day. Now that we have our forked build of DOSBox, we need to extract it from the zip. Navigate into the extracted folder, and then to shaders. These .fx files are simple text files, and they tell the Direct3D video output how to scale the pixels for larger resolutions. You'll need to edit one of these to force the full frame update. Which one you edit depends on what kind of shader you want. For purists, none.fx and point.fx are the two closest to vanilla visuals, with point.fx just doing a nearest neighbor upscale. I'll be using point.fx for this tutorial. Since these files are just text, any text editor will work to edit them. As far as editing, all we are doing is adding a single line of code to the very last line of the file. This line is bool force update, colon, force update equals true, and then make sure to save the changes. Now that we have done that, the next step is to configure DOSBox itself. Fortunately, this fork that we are using has a full menu GUI for this type of thing. Go up a level from the shaders folder and run DOSBox.exe. First, we need to set the video output to Direct3D so that we can use the shader file that we configured. This can be found in Video, Output, Direct3D. Next, we need to enable VSync. Video, VSync, on. Then go to Set Rate and set it to your monitor refresh rate. For most this will be 60, but 120 or 144 will be used for faster refresh rate monitors. Finally, go to Video, Direct3D Pixel Shader, and select the .fx file that you added the force update line to. And since we don't want to configure this every single time, we will save this configuration to a file. Go to Main, Configuration, save the current settings, and save it to a .conf file. The default is DOSBox.conf, and I like this naming convention, so I stick with it. Now that your DOSBox is configured to use a Steam controller, we have to get it working with our games. If you have the original files for the game, then all you need to do is add DOSBox.exe as a non-Steam game, and add the location of the game's .exe file into the shortcut's launch options, and everything should work fine. DOSBox will automatically load the DOSBox.conf file that we created for the Steam overlay to work properly. If your DOS game was purchased through GOG, then we have a little bit more work. Luckily, every DOS game purchased through GOG is organized in the same way, so this method will work for any title. For this example, I will be using Bladestone, Aliens of Gold. I'll navigate to the install folder and find the DOSBox folder. This is where DOSBox is stored. Simply delete the contents in here and copy over the files from the SVN build into this folder. Then add the DOSBox.exe in this folder to Steam as a non-Steam game. Now we need to tell the shortcut to use our custom.conf file as well as to run the right game, which we do using a single.conf file that GOG provides in the root of each game's directory. We need to go into the properties of the shortcut and change the launch options. Here, we will use a single command twice, the -conf command. We'll start with -conf, then open quotation, the exact location of the DOSBox.conf file that we made, and then close quotation, space, -conf, open quotation, the exact location of the single.conf, and then a closing quotation again. The final command should look something like mine, just with the correct locations for wherever you install your GOG games to. Hit OK, and then change the shortcut name to whichever game you added the single.conf for, Bladestone in this instance. Now run that shortcut in Steam and experience full Steam controller and overlay support in DOSBox. A quick note, this method only works when you use the same directory structure as GOG, with DOSBox being housed in a folder within the game's install folder. Now you might be asking, I have a Steam controller. How do I go about adding Steam controller support to my Steam purchased DOS games? Well, that's a bit of a difficult question. GOG actually modifies game files and standardizes directory structures, making it quite easy to give a one-size-fits-all approach to applying this fix to any DOS game. Steam doesn't touch game files at all. So not only is there zero consistency in the directory structures, but some games actually come packaged with older versions of DOSBox or are launched through batch files, or any slew of other inconsistencies. So there isn't any way to give a step-by-step method. You can use the same approach of finding DOSBox files and replacing them, but you'll need to find the shortcut or batch file or however the game is launched and edit it. And then if it doesn't run, you'll need to find out ways to incorporate the provided.conf file with your custom one without losing any settings, and it can become a mess real quick. This method will also require some moderate knowledge about DOSBox and isn't for those who don't want to tinker too much. The other option is to basically do what we did with the GOG titles and add the SVN build of DOSBox in a non-Steam game and manually launch the games. This will still require some tinkering, but should be much easier for the novice since most games can simply be run by adding the .exe location to the launch options sections of a DOSBox shortcut. However, this method doesn't have any of the social features like time played or links to discussions and community guides, though you'll still have access to community configs as long as you name the shortcut identically to how Steam labels it. So, there we go. Now you can finally play all those great DOS games with the Steam controller. Stay tuned to the channel as I have two more videos that are parallel to this topic coming soon. One will detail how to easily create a DOS library for quickly adding DOS games to Steam without having to create a new DOSBox folder for each game, and the other is about adding big picture mode banners for your non-Steam games, like your DOS ones.